if we could just linger on the Drake equation for a little bit, we kind of talked about there's a lot of uncertainty in the parameters and the Drake equation itself is very limited. But I think the parameters are interesting in themselves, even if it's limited, because I think each one is within the reach of science, right?
Right.
To get the evidence for.
Yes.
A few I find really interesting. It'd be interesting to get your comment on. So the one with the most variance, I would say, from my perspective, is the length that civilizations last, however you define it. In the Drake equation, it's the length of how long you're communicating.
Yeah, just transmitting.
Just like you said, that's a wrong way to think about it because we can be detecting some other outputs of the civilizations, etc.
Right.
But just if we just define broadly how long those civilizations last, do you have a sense of how long that might last? Like what are the great filters that might destroy civilizations that
yes.
we should be thinking about? What is in and what it? How can science give us more hints on
right.
this topic?
So I, as I mentioned before, operate by the Copernican principle, meaning that, you know, we are not special. We don't live in a special place and not in a special time. And by the way, it's just modesty encapsulated in scientific terms.
Yes.
Right? You're saying, I'm not special. You know, I find conditions here, they exist everywhere.
Yes.
So if you adopt the Copernican principle, you basically say, our civilization transmitted radio signals for 100 years, roughly. So probably it would last another 100 or a few hundred, and that's it. Because we don't live at a special time. So that's, you know, well, of course, if we get our act together and we somehow start to cooperate rather than fighting each other, killing each other, you know, wasting a lot of resources on things that would destroy our planet, maybe we can lengthen that period if we get smarter. But the most natural assumption is to say that we would live into the future as much as we lived from the time that we started to develop the means for our own destruction, yeah. the technologies we have, which is quite pessimistic, I must say. So several centuries, that's what I would give, unless we become more intelligent than the newspapers report every day. Okay, point number one.